My three favorite things are cloud computing, rockets, space, and Lego. Anyway, and this week, all three come together. Yeah, Azure Cloud Computing can now be used on the International Space Station, Azure expands their data center footprint in North America, and the Azure Firewall gets a premium service tier. Premium. If you still haven't signed up for Microsoft Ignite on the 2nd to 4th of March, now's your chance. This 100% online event of all things Microsoft is completely free to attend. And you can use the link in the description to register, and we'll see you there. One of the most pressing questions humanity face currently is this: how do we get edge computing and artificial intelligence capabilities onto the International Space Station? Okay, maybe not the most pressing, but that didn't stop Microsoft, Hewlett Packard Enterprise, and NASA from solving it using HPE's Spaceborne Computer 2. Yes, that is its actual name. And a NASA link, astronauts can now use Azure as the ultimate edge node, or, well, at least when it gets launched. Most of the time, the astronauts can do the computations at the ISS, but if there is a greater demand, they can push the workloads to the Azure cloud. How cool is that? Now, some of the research being performed at ISS includes weather modeling of dust storms with the aim of going to Mars, plant growth in space, and medical stuff to make sure astronauts can stay healthy in space for long periods of time, like traveling to Mars. Of course, this all links back to the Azure Space product, which we covered a few weeks ago. Also, rockets! There are now something like 67 regions in Azure and over 160 data centers, so we need one more, right? The latest US region is announced to be located in Georgia and will be East US 3. I think Microsoft marketing has got so used to announcing new regions that they just have a template where they replace the region name, because this announcement comes with the usual smorgasbords of benefits. Create new local jobs in IT operations, electrical and mechanical engineering, as well as facility security and maintenance. Partner with local communities in all sorts of ways, and it'll use renewable energy, etc., etc. Woohoo! This is a sign, though, that cloud computing resource requirements are growing fast. More cloud! The trusty old firewall is a staple in any network. Azure has the, well, Azure Firewall. And this week, Azure announced the premium version of Azure Firewall. It's an evolution of the Cloud Firewall product, and Microsoft outlines four new features they hope you'll want to use as well. TLS inspection of inbound and outbound connections. Azure Firewall performs the required value-added security functions and re-encrypts the traffic which is sent to the original destination. Intrusion Detection and Prevention System, also known as IDPS, which is rapid detection of attacks by looking for specific patterns. Filter outbound user access to the internet based on categories such as gambling, social media, etc. And finally, the fourth one, URL filtering to filter outbound access to specific URLs, not just fully qualified domain names. Now, the link in the description has a lot more details on this new service, which is currently in preview. Do you like space and rockets and cloud too? If so, give this video a thumbs up and maybe consider subscribing to the channel. I do promise it isn't just my mug that's on there. Much more talented people make content too. So as we say on the Acloud Guru team, when half your team is snowed in and the other half is melting in the sun, but you have to get this week's show out no matter what, seek and you shall cloud. To see you next week, and keep giving us thumbs ups, Cloud Gurus.